I'm going to take my glasses off for 2 seconds. Look at my face. You satisfy yourself whether you think I look in any way Chinese or not. So I'm going to do it. Ready?
后来 ，Madison 罗向娜出生在牙买加，小时候随中国与牙买加混血的母亲罗尼尔移民美国。因为母亲是华人相貌，却带着纯正的牙买加口音，罗向娜小时候经常因此受到同龄孩子的挑衅。
If you say something to me, like "That's not your mother," then I would say "That's my mother." No, it's not. And then I just hit them.
罗肖娜在大学里专门研习牙买加与中国历史。58岁时，她决心完成母亲遗愿，踏上到中国寻找祖先的旅程。
My mother grew up with her father in his shop, along with her mother, until she was 3 years old.
罗肖娜的母亲罗尼尔是由少年时从广东漂洋过海到牙买加谋生的父亲罗定朝与一名牙买加女子所生。父亲罗定朝是广东客家人，最终因为罗家长辈另有婚配，两人便断了姻缘。罗尼尔一直渴望再见到自己的父亲。16岁时，他终于如常找回到父亲经商的地方。
He was not there, but his brothers were there, and they said, "Your father searched for you the entire time, and he just left for China a few months ago, and he's never coming back."
罗肖娜的母亲生下了罗肖娜与她的两个兄弟后移民美国，并从小对他们采用中国式的教育。
When I came home, third grade, I had my report card. I was always at the top of the class. I was only 8 years old. And my mother looked at my report card, frowned, got in my face and said, "I did not come to this country for you to get a B." That's one. My father's favorite saying was, "Any man who goes to work for another man and collects one paycheck is a fool."
这种教育让罗肖娜从小有很强的企业家意识。在到中国寻根的路途上，罗肖娜发现这种企业家意识与中国外祖父罗定朝的客家精神不谋而合。
The Hakka women are the only women in China who never bound their feet because they had to make money, they had to care for families, and they fought in the wars alongside the Hakka men.
经过一年的寻根之旅，罗向娜几经坎坷，终于在广东与外祖父家族重逢，并在罗家家谱上被列为第151代子孙。虽然他与中国家人语言不通，但血脉亲情。却将他们从世界的两端紧密地连接在了一起。现在经常在中美两国穿梭的罗肖娜被中国客家人称为家族 CEO， 他们共同创建了中美跨国贸易。罗肖娜还称要自己的子孙学习粤语和普通话，她把自己的经历写成了书，拍成了纪录片，终于完成了母亲的遗愿。
罗城18台记者宋小云、孙梦一采访报道。